death penalty exists in 34 states of the United States of America. Currently, only 16 states actually perform executions. Utah is the only state that allowed the honor firing squad. As German, Mingram if and Hillgrown, and being as in the United States, risk treat a bee with practice cattle nishant. This is the Polunsky unit in Livingston, Texas. All male death row inmates of the state, more than 300 of them, are held here. Since this unit does not have a death house, executions are carried out in Huntsville at the Walls unit, some 40 miles away. Cell blocks for those who wait to be killed look like this one. In June of 2010, I met Michael Perry here. He was executed 8 days from the time of this conversation.
But, you know, because I'll forget. I'll literally forget. And then I look at my calendar, I'll hear someone say something, I'll be like, man. And I'll sit back and I'll just stare at the wall and I'll be like, man, 8 days, 7 days, 6 days or whatever. And it's like, it's just, I must not be comprehending the fact that it's that close, because, you know, it's hard for me to say, you know what, like I talked about, you know, in 8 days, these people want to murder me. Yeah, I just can't allow myself to think, like, I can't even picture myself laying on a gurney, but if it happens, I'll have to deal with it, huh?
After our interview, used for a different film, I noticed this man, Joseph Garcia, with whom I had been in contact through letters. He was waiting to be taken back to his cell after having spoken to a reporter. Like all the men here, his mind was consumed with his impending fate.
I don't know how the drugs work, per se. I mean, I understand from what I've read that the first one is to make you basically unconscious, you know. The second drug is to stop your lungs, and then the third one is to stop your heart. It's a wild concept to think about that, you know, you're gonna be put to sleep, euthanized, you know, like a dog.
Does it frighten you?
Yes, it does. Yes, it does.
Garcia is one of the infamous Texas Seven. He is on death row for the murder of a police officer, a crime that was committed after a spectacular prison break.
All of you who were involved in this escape are charged with capital murder.
Basically, yeah, the law states that on the law parties, if you are convicted, that because of your co-defendants' responsibilities in that crime, that you are held responsible along with them. It's a crazy law, you know, because how can you say, you know, if you and I were doing a crime and you decided to kill somebody, how can I be responsible for what you did? You know, I wasn't
so. You were not, you personally were not plotting, let's kill this officer who is driving up the ramp, where you were burglarizing a store for weapons.
Exactly. I wasn't even out on the back dock when that happened. You know, I was still in the store tying up hostages.
Yes.
You know, when that activity, I mean, when that.
Yeah,
when
which
that
was bad enough, let's face it.
Yeah.
You have been in serious crimes, there's no doubt.
The prison museum in Huntsville contains mannequins of the bad guys. The Texas Seven feature prominently among them. Here, Joseph Garcia. The mastermind, however, was George Rivas, who had a long rap sheet for robberies.
I was robbing businesses with a handgun. And I would either pose as security or as a late shopper and take over the store. Then using the clothing of the employees there, I'd go and empty the safe and whatever I could carry and then leave. My first conviction of the first robbery, I ended up with 10 aggravated life sentences for one storm.
But there was no murder, there was no bloodshed.
No, what they did here in Texas, they say here in Texas that If I'm telling you that this is a robbery, and one of your coworkers hears me, they count it as two robberies now. And whatever amount of employees are in the store, or customers, but there was always employees only, no customers, they charged me with an individual count of kidnapping because I told them to move from point A to point B during the commission of a crime. I came out with 10 aggravated life sentences.
Consecutive?
Yes, that means stacked. That means I had to do the time, which was, in 93, it was 15 years before you're eligible for parole. So I had to do 15 years on one life and then start the parole process for the second life, and so on to 10. Well, in June of 95, I was again tried for another robbery. And this time it was, again, the two counts of aggravated robbery and five employees this time. So another 7 aggravated life sentences stacked on top of the first 10. So now I have 17 life sentences.
And then, do I see it right? You were some sort of a gentleman robber. You
yes,
would
sir.
Explain that you like to have all the employees together and ask
yes,
them, don't do anything stupid.
Yes, in fact, one time I had a person in one of the robberies tell me to shoot him. And I had to talk him out of it. He had a very long day. He was very stressful. And he actually testified in his report. In his report to the police, he actually admitted all this. But I actually had to talk him out of shooting him. He had such a hard day, and I had to talk him down out of it. It was a surreal experience, and it's one of the things that started making me aware of how what I was really doing was stupid, to put it bluntly. Within a year and 3 months of being arrested in 93, I had 18 aggravated life sentences. I had more time than all mass murderers in the prison system that I know of. And
did it make you angry? Did you feel that this was out of proportion?
I know I belonged in prison. I was robbing. And I grew up mentally here in prison, and I recognize that I did commit the crimes. I should have been sentenced to prison, but I do believe that they went overboard. They took away all hope for me. And when you do that to a person, anything is possible. Some people go crazy, some people kill themselves, and other people sometimes try to do what I did later on.
Prison rules dictate that there must be a hiatus of at least 3 months before any follow-up discourse with a prisoner. Authorities do not want an inmate to become a regular on TV. In our case, it was 4 months before we met Garcia again. In studying his case, I was interested in tracing back his life to an incident which could have happened to any one of us.
For me, the interesting thing is his tiny little details that are very average, everyday things all of a sudden lead to catastrophic events. In your case, a conviction, 50 years in prison. 50 years.
50 years?
Yes.
50 years. That was...
Can we go back into the evening?
The fatal night ended here, but it started harmlessly enough. After an evening in a bar, Joseph Garcia ended up at the house of a young woman, together with his friend Bobby and another young man, Miguel Luna, whom he had never met before.
What happened there?
I remember